Hey, what's going on, campers? Camp Facer here. Welcome back to another Texas Chainsaw Massacre the Game video. Today is a short and sweet update. Today, Gun Interactive mentioned over on their Twitter that in the next couple of weeks, including this week, they're going to be showing off in-game screenshot teasers to the fans. Let's hear what they had to say. In the coming days and weeks, we'll be showcasing some in-game screenshots from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. At the beginning of a match, victims are strung up like cattle after they've been captured by the family. Okay, so like I said before, if you guys haven't heard of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the game, it's being released by Gun Interactive, the same developers that worked on Friday the 13th, the game. This time, the game is going to be a 3v4, which is three killers versus the four victims. And it's based on the 1974 Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie. It's an asymmetrical multiplayer horror game. It's coming out sometime this year in 2023. There's no exact release date just yet. But again, they're showing off screenshots. We've got the trailers. They've been talking about the game. There's the official link to their website in the description below with all the details. So if you guys want to look deep and go back from the past of what we've got this past year about this game, please go check the link out. But we're going to talk about this screenshot right here. Now, it looks to be like Julie, one of the victims, is tied up to the ceiling here. And it looks like she's hanging maybe like a couple inches from the ground. And it's a very dark screenshot. And it puts us in that scary moment of like, oh crap, where are we? What's around me in this room? How do I get off this rope or hook or get out of this situation here? Now, before I even talk more about getting out of that situation, let's talk about what we see in the upper right-hand corner, and it says the South Cell. Now, you guys, going back a little bit, Gun, they have talked about the three maps that we're getting in this game to start up, which is the Slaughter Family House, the Gas Station map, and the Slaughter Factory map. Now, South Cell sounds like a basement back corner to a big factory to me. It doesn't sound more like a something you would see in the family home. I could be wrong, but it sounds like this is in the Slaughter Factory here. And hung up like cattle, so there's a hint, like what they said in the post I just read off to you guys. And maybe this is part of where they hang the cow meat or whatever, what have you, in this south cell. So, now in the center of the screen, it looks to be like a skill check with an X and then a volume above the X on a different skill check like bar. Now, I don't know exactly what this is all about, but my guess is the one in the middle that goes around the X is the main skill check that we have to complete to get off that rope. Now, the one on the left that has the volume icon, I want to say, correct me if I'm wrong, I don't know, this is all a guess, but if every time you mess up the X skill check, I want to say that one on the left with the icon grows more and more. And if it fills all the way to the top of the volume, I want to say that the Slaughter Family killers can all pinpoint where you're located by making noise. So you don't want to mess up too much and have that, because then you're going to be in a situation where you're not even off the rope yet. And by the time you get off, they could come in that room and chop you up for barbecue. I mean, look below our feet. If you look real close, it looks like there's a bunch of guts. So I want to say this has happened before and somebody didn't get out of that situation. So now I know this is a very dark pick and Gun wants to show this, but I'm going to tweak up the brightness a little bit just so we can get a sense of what's around us and in the environment around us and see what's on the walls and stuff, because I think this is a lot of fun to do. Okay, so as you can see, Julie's hanging there a few inches off the ground. There's a bunch of guts. There's some newspaper to the left-hand side of the screen, and above that it looks to be some bones hanging from a rope. And if you look really close, there's a water meter connected to a pipe, and there's a bunch of different, like, you know, in the water meter around the clock there's a bunch of gauges with different readings. So I don't know. That tells me that's part of something that's running the main factory, the water pressure and stuff. So I can't see that being in the house. But behind her, there's also like a little, it looks like a tunnel with two tin doors with a piece of wood blocking the doors. Maybe that's a way to go and crawl through there and escape, or to start the escape from that situation. But with it being so dark in the game, I can imagine how hard it's going to be to find little things like that and work your way out. But to me, that's terrifying because I want to be scared. I want it to be dark and hard to see. If it was lit up bright like this, it wouldn't be as fun. But I'm just showing you guys kind of what's going on in the detail of this photo. But anyways, I want to say thank you guys for watching. Be on the lookout for more screenshots and news and updates on the game, because here at camp, I'm going to bring all the news to you guys. So make sure again to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next videos. And as always, campers, stay out of the woods.